What up, reader fam? Today I am turning into a book investigator, but before I get started off with that, I'm going to share with you what inspired this video. This video is being sponsored by Freeform in support of Sarah Shepherd's new series, The Amateurs. Now, you probably recognize the name Sarah Shepherd because of Pretty Little Liars. That's her, like, most famous series, but this is the first in a new series by Sarah Shepherd that came out on November 1st, and we follow these teens who get themselves wrapped up in this high-profile case. This case follows this girl who has disappeared, and once the teens kind of get involved with the case, they realize that it wasn't the best idea. Things just automatically start going wrong, but does that stop them? Heck no techno. They get completely wrapped up in the case, they're addicted to it, and they want to get to the bottom of it. It sounds like a fun, adventurous, and sometimes creepy story, so if it sounds good to you, definitely go check it out and give it a go. So basically, inspired by this book, today I'm going to be a book detective. I'm going to be looking into some YA books and kind of theorizing what some of my favorite characters might be up to today. As you guys know, I'm like the worst at theorizing things, but that's not gonna stop me from figuring out some YA cold cases. I'm gonna try to be vague with everything so I don't spoil anything, but without further ado, let's get started. Let's crack some cases! First up, we've got We Were Liars. Now, if you've read this book, you know that our main character in the story went through a lot. Like, a lot. So I'm really hoping that our main character, after this book, just went and got some serious help because she needed some serious help. Like, if they didn't get her a therapist or something along those lines to work out her issues, they're nuts. I'm trying to be very vague here, but the situation that she dealt with in this story was kind of terrifying, not gonna lie. Like, I can't imagine going through what she went through because it is cray cray. Speaking of characters that need therapy or just help in general, Charlie from The Perks of Being a Wallflower. I know that in the end of this book he was seeking some serious help, but I hope that he continued on to get help because what he dealt with isn't a thing that just kind of goes away. I know that if there was a sequel to this book, I would probably hate it. But I'd still be okay with Stephen Chbosky writing another one because I need to know what up with my perk squad. Like, where the heck did everyone end up? Is our little Tootsie Roll Charlie being protected at all costs? Did he and Sam end up together living a life feeling infinite? What's going on with Patrick? Did he ever find love? These are the things that keep me up at night. I'm just so curious as to what's going on with these characters, where their lives ended up. I do think that this story has been told and that expanding on it would be a bad idea. If there were ever to be a sequel, I honestly do not think that it would live up to the perks of being a wallflower. Next up, I've got Eleanor and Park, and I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I was not satisfied with this ending at all. Like, you've got to be kidding me! You can't just leave us hanging that way, Rainbow Rowell! And you better be working on that sequel called Park and Eleanor, where we follow Park and Eleanor living a perfect life together. Obviously not the most perfect life, because we need some drama thrown in there to make the story interesting. So maybe one day Eleanor decides to shave off all her curly red hair, and Park decides that he wants to throw out all his comic books, and their children have to reel them in and wake them up from their midlife crisis. Sounds about right to me. Now on to Fangirl, another Rainbow Rowell book that just leaves you feeling unsatisfied. I just leave Rainbow Rowell's books wanting more, and I feel like they're always kind of like an open-ended ending. So I want a sequel where Kath and Levi are prepping for their wedding day, and everything's going all fine and dandy, until Levi accidentally deletes one of Kath's fanfiction documents, and it causes friction in their relationship. But then everything turns out okay in the end, and they get married and live happily ever after the end. Finally, the trio that I am constantly thinking about is the Baudelaire Orphans from the A Series of Unfortunate Events series. I've always just been so curious as to where they ended up, what they're doing with their lives, what kind of jobs they have. I mean, I know that Klaus is probably doing something with books, like he's either working in publishing, he's a librarian, or he even might be a writer himself. And I'm sure that Violet is making all sorts of nifty inventions. But like, what the crap do we think Sunny is up to? Like, what kind of job did she get where she can use her teeth? Or was that just like a childhood phase? Did she grow out of that? I always thought that Lemony Snicket could carry on this story, and I know that this is a crazy long series, but when you've got these incredibly crafted characters like these ones, you can give us more. Especially when you give us that wimpy ending that was the 13th book. Like, come on, Mr. Snicket, you can do better. So those are some of my book investigations, if that's what you want to call them. Those are just some characters that I would love to know what are up to these days. You guys should let me know down below a story that ended that you just wanted more closure from. Also, again, if The Amateurs sounds interesting to you, definitely go and pick up this book. It's in stores now. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. I post videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, so click subscribe if you want to be notified for when I post new videos. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you soon with a new video. Bye, choo. What up, reader fam? Today, I'm going to be sharing with you 5 books that I am thankful for.